We want to complete the table below by finding P, the amount that must be invested at 4% interest compounded continuously to obtain a balance of A equals $50,000. So because we're told the account pays continuous interest, we're using the continuous interest formula A equals P times E raised to the power of R times T. But what's different about this problem is that we're given A, the amount after time T is equal to $50,000, and we're solving for P, the initial amount or the initial investment. Let's start by identifying the given information. Notice how the account pays 4% continuous interest, so R, the interest rate, is equal to 4%, which must be expressed as a decimal, which would be 0.04. And we're also told that the amount after time t must be $50,000, so we know A is equal to 50,000. And then the time t is going to change based upon the information from the table. It'll be either 1 year, 5 years, or 10 years. And again, we're trying to find P, the initial amount, for these values of T. So because we're trying to find P, let's solve the continuous interest formula for P. To do this, notice how we would divide both sides by E raised to the power of R times T. So on the right side now, this simplifies to 1, so we just have P equals A divided by E raised to the power of R times T. So let's go ahead and change the order of this equation and write P equals A divided by E raised to the power of R times T. Now if we wanted to, we could write this a different way, which you'll sometimes see in textbooks. We could move this up to the numerator, which would change the sign of the exponent. This is also equal to A times E raised to the power of negative R times T. But we'll go ahead and use the formula in this form here, where we have a quotient. So using our formula, we'll have P is equal to A, which is $50,000, divided by E raised to the power of R times T, where R is 0.04, and we'll leave T in the equation because it will be either 1, 5, or 10. And now we'll go to the calculator to find P based upon the value of T. So first, T is equal to 1, so we'll have 50,000 divided by E raised to the power of 0.04 times 1. Of course, the times 1 is optional. Enter. So when T equals 1, P is equal to $48,039.47. Which means we'd have to invest this amount today in this account that pays 4% continuous interest if they wanted $50,000 after 1 year. Now let's find P if T equals 5 years. If we press second enter, we can edit the previous entry, so now we'll change the 1 to 5 for T equals 5. Press enter. When T equals 5, the initial investment would have to be $40,936.54. Now it should make sense that P is less if T is 5 years, since we have 5 years to earn interest, whereas when T is 1, we only have 1 year to earn interest to obtain the $50,000. And after the last question, T is 10. So I'm going to press second enter and then change the 5 to a 10 since T is now 10 years. Running to the nearest penny, this would be $33,516. Notice once again the initial investment is less since now we have 10 years to earn interest to end up with a balance of $50,000. Okay, that's going to do it for this example. I hope you found this helpful.